Hi dear children, how are you? In the last class we studied one animal fiber, wool. Wool is obtained from sheep, goat, yam, etc. And it is converted into there is one long process. The fibers are converted into woolen cloths. Shearing, sorting, scouring, there are the several steps. Then already we studied that's several steps. Then today we are going to study about the next animal fiber is silk fiber, silk. The silk is an animal fiber. Silk fibers are also animal fiber. For rearing of silkworms, obtaining silk is called sericulture. What is sericulture? The rearing of silkworms for obtaining silk fiber is called sericulture. It's called sericulture. What is sericulture? The rearing of silkworms for obtaining silk fiber is called sericulture. The female silk moth lays eggs and they hatch into larva is called caterpillar. Fourth class you learned, you know, life history of silk moth. Then the female silk moth lays eggs and they hatch into larva is called caterpillar. What is called? Caterpillar. Their growing size and when the caterpillar is ready to enter in the next stage of its life history, it is called pupa. What is called? Pupa. It first weaves a net to hold itself. Then it swings from herd to side to side in the form of figure of eight. Form of figure of eight. During these movements of the caterpillar, they secrete the fibers made of a protein which hardens on exposure to air to become silk fibers. Soon, the caterpillar completely covers its body with the silk fibers and this stage is called the cocoon. What is called the cocoon? Already studied in all our class. The life history of silkworm. Yes, but the next stage is the cocoon stage. The first one caterpillar, then pupa, then cocoon stage. In this stage, caterpillar converted into the silk moth. The larva it converted into silk moth. Okay, then the silk fibers are used for making silk cloths. Okay, the most common silk moth is mulberry silk moth. The silk fiber from the cocoon of this moth is soft, lustrous and elastic, and it can be dyed in beautiful colors. Okay, but the life history of silk moth, first stage is caterpillar, then next stage pupa, then last stage cocoon. After that they hatch into one beautiful silk moth. The life history of silk moth, and the first stage is caterpillar, the second stage is pupa, the last stage is cocoon. In these stages, the caterpillar takes complete development. After that, it forms a silk moth. The next one is rearing of silkworm. We already studied the female silk moth lays hundreds of eggs and they carefully collect and keep it in a strip of paper or cloth and sold to the farmers. The farmers kept these eggs under hygienic conditions. During these hygienic conditions, like temperature and humidity, the eggs are warmed and they hatches into larva. It is called caterpillar, which is done by on mulberry trees to bear a fresh crop of leaves. The caterpillar eats day and night to these mulberry leaves and it increases enormously size and they are kept into one bamboo tray. After 25 to 30 days, they stop eating and they move to the tiny chamber of this bamboo tray. and the farmers maybe added some ticks on the bamboo tree. And the caterpillar, they secrete the silk fibers, and they are get attached to these small ticks. And this stage is cocoon stage. The caterpillar completely covers its body with these silk fibers. A pile of cocoon is used for making silk fibers. The farmers collect these cocoons and kept under the sun or give steam, and the silk fibers are separated out. So the process of separating silk fibers from the cocoon is called reeling of the silk. What is called? Reeling of the silk. Reeling of silk. What is called? Reeling of silk. Separation of silk fibers from the cocoon is called reeling of silk. And these silk fibers are used for making different types of silk cloths. What is reeling of silk? The silk fibers are separated from the cocoon. This process is called the reeling of silk. And the silk fibers are collected by the weavers and they weave silk cloth. Do you understand? Okay, so today we are studying the life history of silk moth. The silk is one animal fiber. It is obtained from silk moth, and this is called sericulture. Rearing of silkworm is called sericulture. The first stage of life history of silk moth, first stage caterpillar, that is larvae. Second stage pupa. And the next stage cocoon stage. Then what we study? The processing of silk fibers into silk cloth. First the female lays, the female silk moth lays hundreds of eggs and they hatch into larva or caterpillar. They enter in the next stage pupa, and then after that they secrete some fibers which is made of protein, and it exposes on air and becomes converted into silk fiber. And this stage is cocoon stage, and further development takes place inside the cocoon stage. And the farmers collect a pile of cocoons and it kept under the sunlight, and it separated the silk fibers from this silk moth. And this process is called the reeling of silk. Dear children, our third lesson is over. Everybody should read the textbook carefully. If you have any doubt, you call me. The next class, we will meet again. Then, thank you, dear children. Bye.